The Bitcoin and crypto industry has arrived in Washington, D.C. in a very, very public way. But as Jack Dorsey so eloquently said yesterday, Bitcoin doesn't need presidents. And as I added to it, Bitcoin doesn't need presidents, but presidents need Bitcoin. Joe and John, you both have spent much less time in the Bitcoin and crypto world. You, over time, have become more excited about it. You're younger, both in your 20s. What's your view on this entire legislative battle that's going on right now in Washington?
Well, I think you nailed it when you're talking about it. As much as Bitcoin will help you learn economics and how money works and everything like that, it's also now teaching us about politics, right? And when you think about politicians, historically, their main job is they work for the people, right? And they are out there to incentivize economic innovation within our country, create jobs, and make sure people live a good, happy life, essentially, right? And what we're seeing now is that they've spent days and hundreds of hours and thousands of articles have been written and tons of arguments have happened back and forth about the specific vernacular that's used in an infrastructure bill that none of them have not only read, like Ted Cruz pointed out, but in an industry they have absolutely no idea of anything about. None of them even understand it, mostly. And I think what we're realizing is that they're not there to help the people, right? They're not there to determine what is good for innovation within this country. It's something they don't understand. It's something that is dividing party lines currently. But I think if they really did understand it, they would have a different viewpoint on it. And I think more importantly, what we're going to see play out now is we're going to see Bitcoin become an important topic from a fundraising perspective within government and a marketing perspective within government. So one of the interesting things I saw last night on Twitter was from one of my friends, Matias Dorta, and he pointed out that two of the senators that wanted to back an amendment and put forward an amendment changing the vernacular used in the infrastructure bill, more pro-crypto and understand the industry better than some of the other participants in Senate, Senator Wyden and Senator Toomey. Last month on Twitter, each of them gained 200 followers and 750 followers, respectively. This month, they gained 4,000 to 5,000 followers each. Right. So when you look at it from the aspect of Bitcoin is the strongest community in the world, and you really do not understand it until you start to get involved with it. And it's something that you learn very quickly, whether you're pro crypto or against crypto and specifically Bitcoin. They're passionate. They care and they'll tell you their opinion. Right. And I think when you start to see politicians play one way or the other, it's going to have a massive impact on their political future.
John, what do you think?
Yeah, Joe just hit it on the head. They're definitely passionate and they definitely care more than most other industries. A couple things is, I think this kind of stops innovation, which we should be celebrating and advising people to do, right? So Cuban had a good quote talking about shutting off this growth engine, speaking of crypto, would be the equivalent to stopping e-commerce in 1995 because people were afraid of credit card scams. It just talks about how when you don't understand something and the power of something, you want to make sure that you don't actually stop the innovation in that sector. And then Ted Cruz absolutely nailed it on the head. His 3 points were they don't understand it, haven't read the bill, and they spending money on stuff we can't afford, which is the perfect way to, I think, say it.
What Joe described, and John, I think what you're getting at as well, is that Bitcoin is good for business,
yeah,
right? If you're a private company and you accept Bitcoin, you empower Bitcoin, you participate in the Bitcoin network, if you put Bitcoin in your balance sheet, it's good for business. If you're a public company, go look at Square and Tesla, MicroStrategy, and all these different companies. It's good for business. And now what we're watching is that the political class is learning. There is a line in the sand. There are people that are in their district that are changing their Twitter names, that are changing their bios, that are going on to these public forums and saying, I am a single issue voter. This is all that matters to me. Either you're with us or you're against us. And if you're against us, we got a lot of money. We got a really big and passionate community, and we're going to kick you out of your seat. And I think that what we are about to watch is a scenario where some politicians already understand this, right? If you look, there's a ton of politicians that get how powerful this community is, how engaged it is, and how right they likely are about where we're going. But there's a lot of politicians that are going to get run over by it. And I would not be surprised when the next election cycle comes up if multiple people that are in office today get kicked out and replaced by young people who understand this technology and who simply run and say, this person has no clue about technology, nor do they understand anything about where the world is going, right? The average age of these people is
63 years old in Senate.
63 years old. We have people who are 63 years old who are voting on legislation that they didn't read about topics that they don't understand. It's nuts. And the fact that they are being encouraged makes it even worse, because whether it's the current administration, whether it is the mainstream media, or whether it's a bunch of other 63-year-olds that are yelling and screaming and saying, screw those people. There are people who literally are on Twitter who have been encouraging this stuff and saying things like, oh, the money launderers just want more power. They want more ability to launder money. When the data shows less than 0.5% of all transactions in Bitcoin and crypto actually are illicit transactions. Right? That separate studies, independent studies have shown this. The former CIA director came out and said that there was very, very little illicit activity happening in the industry, because it's a fully transparent system. Literally, the young people built a system that the old people have been screaming for decades, and the politicians are too stupid to actually realize what the young people built. A fully transparent system and a programmatic system that nobody controls. And one that cannot be changed unless the majority of people agree. It is the ultimate vision for what a financial system should be. But still, they continue to do dumb things.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching that clip of The Best Business Show. Make sure you like and subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications so you know when we go live every weekday, and then head to SoFi.com/pomp so that you can get an account and we can get after it.